Hello students, welcome to SRM Biology classes. Today's topic is adaptations. In organisms and population, you are having an important short notes concept called adaptation. In a valid terminology, the adaptation is defined as the physical, physiological, morphological and behavioral adjustment of the living organism to survive and reproduce in that habitat. In that habitat is purely designated as adaptation. The physical, physiological, morphological and behavioral adjustment of the living organism to survive and reproduce in that particular habitat is purely designated as adaptation. The adaptation is one of the basic characteristic features of the living organism to survive and to reproduce in that particular geographical area with the exhibition of physical adaptation. One of the classical example is in case of polar bear, it normally lives in the Arctic and in the Antarctic zone. You can find the presence of very low intensity of sunlight. Because of that unique characteristic feature, you can't expect the presence of dark coloration. You can't expect the presence of dark coloration of the ears in case of polar bear. In addition to this. In conformity with the surrounding environmental conditions, the polar bear physiologically it exhibits the phenomenon of hibernation, popularly called winter sleep, in order to prevent the adverse environmental conditions. Morphologically, in order to conserve the body temperature, it is scattered by the presence of very short limbs, followed by the presence of narrow nostrils. With reference to the behavioral adaptation seen in case of polar bear, it undergoes winter sleep with the onset of winter season. It is a behavioral change seen in case of polar bear. Yes, the adaptation is defined as the physical, physiological, morphological, biochemical and behavioral adjustment of the living organism to survive, to reproduce in that particular habitat is purely designated as adaptation. Some of the classical examples with reference to adaptations are namely the kangaroo rat living in the North American deserts is one of the classical example in favor of adaptation. The presence of succulents in the desertic conditions is another classical example. The last important one is The presence of mammalian population in the colder climatic conditions is another classical example with reference to adaptations. The first important classical example is with reference to the presence of kangaroo rat in the North American deserts, is one of the classical example for adaptation. In the North American deserts, you can find the presence of an unique state called Arizona State. In the Arizona State, you can find the presence of desertic environmental conditions. It receives very low amount of rainfall. In addition to this, you can find the presence of extreme temperature. You can find the presence of extreme temperature followed by the high intensity of sunlight will favor the luxuriant growth and proliferation of gigantic opuntia population in that particular geographical area. Even in such a desertic environmental conditions, you can find the presence of kangaroo rat. You can find the presence of kangaroo rat. With reference to the physical, physiological, morphological, biochemical and behavioral adaptation seen in case of kangaroo rat. In order to avoid the extreme temperature followed by the high intensity of sunlight, the kangaroo rat, it started to feed only during the nocturnal conditions. In addition to this, if it started to move in the day conditions, it exhibits hopping mechanism. With the hopping mechanism, it gives the name kangaroo rat. Compared to four limbs, it is characterized by the presence of hind limbs. With the hind limbs, it exhibits hopping mechanism. In addition to this, in order to obtain water, it exhibits very slow rate of fat metabolism. During the lifespan, it never drinks not even a single drop of water. With the exhibition of lipid metabolism, it gains enough amount of cellular water. In order to maintain all the biochemical activities in case of kangaroo rat. In addition to this, it is characterized by the presence of very narrow nostrils. In addition to this, during the day condition, it started to survive in the deep of the burrows. With the deep of the burrows, it will survive very luxuriantly even in the desertic environmental conditions. In addition to this, with a hopping mechanism, the minimum body is exposed or it will comes in contact with the ground. Thereby, it exhibits the optimum body temperature. In addition to this, the hairs in case of kangaroo rats are hygroscopic in nature. Thereby, it absorbs the atmospheric moisture in order to maintain the optimum body temperature. Such a unique type of physical, physiological, morphological and behavioral adaptations are seen in case of kangaroo rat even in such a desertic environmental conditions. You can find the luxuriant growth and proliferation of kangaroo rat in case of North American deserts. The second classical example is the presence of plants in the deserts is another classical example with reference to adaptation. With reference to the presence of plants in the desertic environmental condition. In the desertic environmental conditions, the average temperature is very high. It receives very minimum amount of rainfall. Very little amount of rainfall in the rainy season. Even in such a ash environmental conditions, you can find the presence of xerophytic plants. One such xerophytic plants luxuriantly found in the desertic environmental conditions, it is called Opuntia. It is a type of succulent. In order to conserve the water, in case of Opuntia, the leaves are modified into spines. The stem is photosynthetic in nature. The stem will perform the function of photosynthesis. In addition to this, if stomata are present, it is deeply seated. In addition to this, biochemically, it exhibits Krasnusian acid metabolism. In addition to this, in order to protect the plant against the grazing animals, the spines naturally provides defensive mechanism against the grazing animals, against the predators. In addition to this, the stem is leafy-like. It will perform the function of photosynthesis. In addition to this, the roots are entered deep into the earth crust in order to absorb each and every trace of water present in the soil. It is profusely branched and it is entered deep into the earth crust. Such a unique type of morphological, physical, behavioral and physical adaptation are seen in case of Opuntia. With this adaptation, even today you can find the presence of Opuntia population in the desertic environmental conditions. It is in conformity with the surrounding environmental conditions. The next important classical example is with reference to the presence of mammals. The presence of mammals in the colder regions of the world. In the Arctic and in the Antarctic zone, you can find the presence of very low temperature. Even in such a low environmental conditions, you can find the presence of wide variety of mammalian population. In the Arctic and in the Antarctic zone or in the polar region, you can find the presence of polar bear. With the exhibition of Allen's rule. It exhibits physical, physiological, morphological, biochemical and behavioral adaptation. With reference to Allen's rule, in conformity with the very low temperature in the polar region, it is characterized by the presence of narrow nostrils in order to conserve the body temperature. In addition to this, you can find the presence of short limbs in order to conserve the body temperature. In the polar region, you can find the presence of only two seasons, namely winter season and summer season. With the onset of winter season, a 40 kg weighing polar bear with a vigorous feeding behavior, it will slowly raise the body weight to more than 400 kgs. With that massive body weight, soon after the approach of the winter season, it undergoes a behavioral change called hibernation. Soon after the approach of the favorable condition, it will break its hibernation and it will start to live a normal life. It will start to live a normal life. In addition to this, during the course of hibernation, with the exhibition of fat metabolism, it takes part in the synthesis of enough amount of water to maintain all the biochemical activities in case of polar bear. In addition to this, you can find the presence of majority of fishes, polar seal in case of polar region. In case of polar seal, you can find the presence of a fatty layer called blubber. With the blubber, it will maintain the body temperature. In addition to this, the blubber will act as an insulator, thereby even in the cold regions or even in the cold climatic conditions, you can find the presence of seal and you can find the presence of polar bear population in the colder regions of the world. The next important aspect is with reference to the types of adaptations. You can find the presence of three types of adaptations, namely physiological adaptation, biochemical adaptation, and behavioral adaptation. The first important one is called physiological adaptation. The next important aspect is behavioral adaptation. The last important one is the biochemical adaptation are the three important types of adaptation seen in case of living organism from the point of NCERT. The first important one is called physiological adaptation. If you started to move to the higher altitudes, normally you will get nausea, vomiting sensation, fattiness is resulted. In addition to this, you started to exhibit heart palpitations. Vigorous heartbeat is seen in case of human beings if you started to move to the higher altitudes. It is purely because of the presence of very less amount of oxygen in the higher altitudes. Soon after a few minutes, your body will start to exhibit acclimatization. Your body started to exhibit adjustment to the surrounding environmental conditions with the experience of altitude sickness, our body will started to respond to the, our body will started to adapt to the surrounding environmental conditions with the exhibition of physical, physiological, morphological, biochemical, and behavioral adaptation. With reference to altitude sickness, in order to adjust the body to the surrounding environmental conditions, we started to experience vigorous breathing. As a result of vigorous breathing, the body will started to adjust the low oxygen availability by increasing the number of RBC production. By increasing the number of RBCs, even in the low oxygen condition, we started to survive. In addition to this, the hemoglobin, we started to decrease the binding capacity. Hemoglobin, it shows ID graph affinity toward the oxygen. The hemoglobin started to decrease the binding capacity. With a decreased binding capacity, followed by the increasing the rate of breathing, the organism will start to adjust to the surrounding environmental condition by experiencing altitude sickness. In the altitude sickness, the body will start to produce more number of RBCs. We started to exhibit vigorous breathing. In addition to this, the hemoglobin, we started to decrease the binding capacity. With oxygen, by increasing the rate of breathing, will play a very important role in exhibiting adaptation in conformity with a higher altitude. The next important aspect is with reference to behavioral adaptation. In the desertic environmental conditions, you can find the presence of wide variety of lizards. In the warming, in order to raise the body temperature of the lizards, they exhibit sunbasking. With the exhibition of sunbath to the sun, the body temperature is slowly raised. When it reaches to the normal condition, it started to move to the shade and it will started to take rest. Such a unique type of behavioral adaptation seen in case of lizards living in the desertic environmental condition. With the exhibition of sunbath, it will start to raise the body temperature. When it reaches to the normal condition, it will move to the shade condition. Whenever it faces the decrease in the temperature, again it exhibits the same behavioral adaptation. In addition to this, even in the polar region, you can find the presence of wide variety of crane and the flamingo population. With the onset of winter season, they exhibit a behavioral change. That unique behavioral change is called migration. From the adverse environmental conditions, it moved to the more hospitable, more congenial environmental conditions. With the exhibition of migration, each and every year, wide variety of bird population from the northern hemisphere or from the colder climatic conditions, it will move toward the warmer conditions. That unique behavioral change, it is in conformity with the very low temperature in that particular geographical area. Such a unique type of migratory behavior in case of birds is an classical example for behavioral adaptation. The next important aspect is with reference to biochemical adaptation. In most of the animals, the metabolic reaction proceeds optimally in a narrow range of temperature. They are highly sensitive to narrow range of temperature. If slight alteration in the temperature, it leads to various alteration in the metabolic activities, leads to death of the microorganism or death of the living organism is resulted. In this aspect, majority of the archaeobacteria, majority of the ancient bacteria living in the extreme habitats, they exhibit biochemical adaptation. One such extremophile or one such hot water springs is in the Kulumanali. You can find the presence of hot water springs. Even in such a hot water springs, you can find the presence of thermophiles. One such microorganism surviving in that geographical area is a bacteria called, a nanobacteria called Thermophilus aquaticus. This Thermophilus aquaticus, it will survive even in the temperature exceeds more than 100 degrees Celsius. With the production of thermostable enzyme called TAC polymerase enzyme, even in such a harsh environmental conditions, few thermophiles will live luxuriantly with the production of thermostable enzymes. In addition to this, majority of fishes will survive in the colder climatic regions of the world. Even in the sub-zero levels in the Arctic, in the Antarctic zonation, you can find the presence of fish variety with the exhibition of biochemical adaptation. Are some of the classical examples in favor of biochemical adaptation are the three important types of adaptation seen in case of living organisms, namely physiological, behavioral and biochemical adaptation. Thank you very much. I will post the MCQs, try to answer. The next important topic is population. That will be studied in the next class. Thank you very much.